In this video, I'm going to work through an example of the food labels activity. In this activity, you're going to have to read labels from two different types of food. Boxed, packaged, or frozen foods all have nutrition labels. Pick two and record the following information for each. Then we'll perform some calculations. I looked in my cupboard and one thing I found was a package of pasta. So this is Barella Mini Wheels Pasta. I'm going to start by writing that as my name of product. For the rest of the information, I'm going to need to turn the box to the side to look at the nutrition label. So the nutrition label is usually on the side or the back of your package. So now we're going to read information from the package and just fill it in. So the serving size is towards the top. It says the serving size is 2 ounces. It also gives it an other units. Put down the one that makes the most sense to you. So 2 ounces for my serving size. Right below the serving size, it says servings per container, about 8. Usually you're going to get the word about as an estimate. Just put 8. So 8 servings. Let's look at total calories. So the calories likely is the next thing down. They usually bold it because it's kind of important. So one serving of pasta has 200 calories. Now I'm looking for information on the nutrients that make it up. So first it says grams of carbohydrates per serving. We want the total carbohydrates. So in this case, total carbohydrates is 42 grams. Next, we're looking for the grams of fat per serving. Grams of fat was the first one listed. Again, we're going to go total fat. Total fat is 1 gram. And then the final one from the label we need is grams of protein. So protein is usually the bottom one. So protein is 7 grams. For the next part of the assignment, we're done reading the labels. Now we'll do our calculations. So all the information we need, we've recorded in 1 through 7 above. We want in number 8, calories from carbohydrates, blank grams of carbs times 4 calories per gram. So I look up in number 5 and I see there's 42 grams of carbohydrates. Now grab my calculator. So 42 grams of carbohydrates times 4 calories per gram gives me 168 calories from carbohydrates. Now let's repeat this for fat. So number 9 says calories from fat. I look up at number 6 to find the grams of fat. I had 1 gram of fat. So I'm going to fill 1 in for grams of fat. So 1 gram of fat times 9 calories per gram. 1 times 9 is 9 calories. And finally, we're going to find the calories from protein. Let's look at the number of grams of protein. In number 7, we found that there were 7 grams of protein per serving. So 7 grams of protein times 4 calories per gram. Use your calculator if you need to. 7 times 4 is 28. That means there are 28 calories in this meal from protein. To find the total calories, number 11 says add the answers from number 7 through 9 to find the total calories. So total calories is going to equal 168 plus 9. Plus 28. So 168 plus 9 plus 28 gives us 205 calories. Let's scroll down to our next part. In this section, we're going to calculate the percent of calories that come from carbohydrates, fat, and protein. To do this, we'll take the individual answers from numbers 8 through 10 and divide it by the total calories in number 11. Then, to turn it into a percent, we multiply by 100. So let's look at number 12. Number 12 says percent of calories from carbohydrates. We're going to take the calories from carbs, which was in number 8, divided by the total calories in number 11, and times that by 100. So on the top of my fraction, I need 168, which is the calories from carbs. On the bottom, I want the total calories. Number 11 said the total calories was 205. So for this part, I will need my calculator. 168 divided by 205 equals 0.8195. To change this to a percent, we move the decimal two places to the right or multiply it by 100. I want to round to the nearest whole number. The 9 tells me to bump up, so that's 82%. Of our calories come from carbohydrates. The calories from fat can be found in number 9. Number 9 says we have 9 calories from fat. The total calories from number 11 is the same as in number 12. That was 205 calories. So we'll change 9 out of 205 to a percent using our calculator. 9 divided by 205 equals 0.0439. Change that into a percent by multiplying by 100 to move the decimal two places to the right. That means we have 4% of our calories from fat. Finally, we're going to find the percent of calories from protein. We'll take the number of calories from protein from number 10, divide it by the total calories in number 11. Looking at number 10, I see that we had 28 calories from protein. I'm going to divide that by my total calories, 205. 28 divided by 205 equals 0.136585. Change it to a percent by multiplying by 100 to move the decimal two places to the right. So 13.658%. I'm going to round to the nearest whole number, which is 14%. Now we'll add these percents together. 82 plus 4 plus 14 equals 100. 100% of the calories come from carbohydrates, fat, or protein. You may want to use this video as an example as you work step by step through your assignment.